In this video, I'm going to talk about a problem. So in this problem, we have four charges, and all the charges are placed at the corner of a square. Q1, Q2, and Q3 are the positive charges, while Q4 is the negative charges. The side of the square is 1 meter, and we are interested in finding out the total electric field at this point, which is at the center of the square. So let's find out first the electric field due to this charge at this point. As this is a positive charge, the electric field is away from the charge. So how do we find out the electric field? So the electric field due to this charge will be away. I'm drawing this one, let's say with this color. So this is the direction of the electric field due to Q1. I'm simply calling E1. And now I'm going to find out the electric field at this point due to Q3. Okay? So at that point, the electric field, this is the electric field, and I'm calling this is an E3. And notice that E1 and E3 are equal and opposite. Why it is equal? Because the distance from this distance and this distance is equal, the magnitude of the charge is equal, so the electric field has to be equal. The formula for calculating the electric field due to a point charge is KQ over R square. In this case, KQ over R square. K is a constant, Q is equal for both charges, R is the same because this is the R. So E1 and E3 are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. What does that mean? That means this electric field and this electric field cancels out each other. So we do not need to worry about finding the magnitude due to E1 and E3. Now let's talk about Q2 and Q4. Q2 is a positive charge. What does that mean? That means the electric field at this point is away. Okay, let's draw this one. This is the direction of the, it has to be this way, a little bit. I'm trying to draw it. Okay, let's call this as an E2. E2, okay. And now, again, due to the Q4 charge, Q4 is negative. And for any negative charge, the electric field is towards the charge. What does that mean now? That means the electric field due to Q4 is again in the same direction. The E4 is also in the same direction. And what does that mean? That means the total charge, the total electric field at this point is the sum of the electric field due to Q2 and Q4. So we have the total electric field now. I'm writing down here. E1 and E3 are equal and opposite. E2 and E4 are equal and in the same direction. In the same direction. So the total electric field So what we have, a total electric field is 2 times K, or how can I write down, is the total electric field is E2 plus E4. And what is the value of E2? Due to this, as these are the point charge, the total electric field can be given by K Q4 over R square. And also due to the Q4, sorry, this has to be Q2. Q2 plus K Q4 over R square. What is R in this case? The R is the distance from the charge to this point. This is R. And how can I find out this R or this R? How can I find this R? This R is equal to, so this R, we can find out this R by looking into this triangle here, this triangle. So this triangle here, the total is 1. From this point to this point is 1. So this is 0.5 meter. And this is again 0.5 meter. So R, this distance is a square root of 0.5 squared plus 0.5 squared. This is R. So we got R now. So R, the distance is simply equal to 0.5 squared plus 0.5 squared. Okay. As Q2 and Q4 are equal in magnitude, so I can write down the total electric field. The total electric field is 2K Q over R square, or Q2, because these two are equal. So I'm simply adding them. Now let's plug in all the values now. 2, K is 9 times 10 to the 9. Q2 is 5 microcoulomb. And R, as we have here, R square is 0.5 square plus 0.5 square. Now let me do the math here. What is this one? I have to write down everything in calculator. So I'm just using my calculator here. What I got is 1,800, 1.8 times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times 10 to the 5. And the unit, this is the electric field value, what I got is a Newton per coulomb. Okay, so check your calculation, but this is how you do it. So, and make sure that you understand this picture here. Last time, E2 and E1 cancel out each other. E2 and E4 are in the same direction. That's how we find out the total electric field.